Hello student, we are providing St. Angel online classes as we are working from home. Today I will discuss class 12 chemistry chapter 8 D and F block elements, and today topic is standard electrode potential. Standard electrode potential I will discuss here E naught M2 plus oblique M. M2 plus means here oxidation state of transition metal is plus 2 here. Oxidation state plus 2 indicate here the oxidation state of transition elements. So now I will explain this standard electrode potential. Standard electrode potential is the sum of the first, second ionization enthalpy, atomization enthalpy and hydration enthalpy. Means if you have to calculate the E naught value of transition metal M2 plus oblique M, then you have to sum here delta I H naught 1 plus delta I H naught 2 plus delta A H naught plus delta hydration H naught. Means first ionization enthalpy delta I H naught means first ionization enthalpy, delta I H naught 2 means second ionization enthalpy, delta A H naught means atomization enthalpy, and this one is the hydration enthalpy. Now you see, if you will add all these value, you will get the standard electrode potential of any ions in plus 2 oxidation state. In this case, first ionization enthalpy, second ionization enthalpy and atomization enthalpy are always positive because it requires some amount of energy means it is endothermic, but hydration enthalpy it always releases some amount of energy, therefore this value will be negative here. So positive or negative value of E naught depends on value of this positive and negative value. If hydration enthalpy will be more negative as compared to first ionization enthalpy, second ionization enthalpy and atomization enthalpy, the E naught value of the transition metal will be negative. And if the hydration enthalpy is less negative and this value is more positive, in that case E naught value will be positive here. So means positive E naught M2 plus M depends on what? If delta I H naught plus delta I H naught 2 plus delta A H naught if greater than delta hydration H naught, and if it is negative M2 plus M, then what will be delta I H naught 1 plus delta I H naught 2 plus delta A H naught will be less than delta hydration H naught. Now you see the E naught value of transition metal. With the help of this graph, now you see the E naught value of some elements of first series transition elements. In this axis we have taken here the E naught value. So E naught value is here 0. This one indicate here, this line indicate here the 0 E naught value, and below this value negative and above this value will be positive here. So now you see all these metals except copper having the negative E naught value, negative E naught value, and only copper in first series having the positive E naught value. Means copper has less negative hydration enthalpy as compared to first, second ionization enthalpy and atomization enthalpy, and rest of the elements having the what? More negative hydration enthalpy as compared to first, second ionization enthalpy and atomization enthalpy. That is why it has the what? Negative value of E naught value. Now you see, this one indicate here delta I H naught, first ionization enthalpy, delta I H naught 2, second ionization enthalpy, A means atomization enthalpy, hydration enthalpy, all these point here. Now, second, next point. The lower the electrode potential, that more negative of standard electrode potential means, lower means negative hydration enthalpy, negative standard electrode potential. If elements having the more negative standard electrode potential, it indicate the more stable oxidation state, more stable oxidation state. And some value is given here, only copper having positive and rest of the elements having the negative, so already value is given here. Next point is here, now you see, due to the positive E naught value of copper, copper having the positive E naught value, copper cannot release hydrogen gas with dilute acid. You know, the any metals react with dilute acid and release the hydrogen gas, but copper cannot release hydrogen gas because copper having positive E naught value, that is why it cannot release hydrogen gas with dilute acid. Second one is here, copper having the positive E naught value, therefore it only can react with the HNO3 strong acid like HNO3 and hot concentrated H2SO4, and other weak acid cannot react with copper because copper having the positive E naught value. Thank you dear, read carefully all these points and try to understand. Thanks.